Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare to begin today's ceremony, please welcome the university's platform party, led by Cleveland State University President Laura Bloomberg and the chair of our trustees, Mr. David Reynolds. Ladies and gentlemen, and now welcome today's University Platform Party, led by Cleveland State University President Laura Bloomberg and the chair of our trustees, Mr. David Reynolds. Thank you.
I declare these commencement exercises to be assembled.
Good morning. Welcome to the 79th commencement exercise of Cleveland State University. I am Nigaman Sridhar, and I have the honor, the privilege, and just the giddy pleasure of serving as Interim Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs for the University. Please stand and join Ms. Madeline Hasbin in singing our national anthem. Thank you, Madeline. Everyone, please be seated. It is my honor now to introduce the esteemed members of the Platform Party. Please stand as your name is announced and remain standing until everyone has been introduced. Richard Schropheister, Dean, Washkowitz College of Engineering. Sajid Zachariah, Dean, College of Education and Human Services. Alison Robichaud, Interim Dean, College of Liberal Arts and Social Sciences. Joanna Ganning, Associate Dean, Maxine Goodman Levin, College of Urban Affairs. Elizabeth Layfeld, Dean, Jack, Joseph, and Morton Mandel Honors College. John Holcomb, Dean, College of Graduate Studies. Laura Bloomberg, President. The Honorable Chantel Brown, Congresswoman and Commencement Speaker. Caleb Palagi, University Valedictorian, Washkowitz College of Engineering. Tashelle Banks, Presidential Faculty Fellow. Sonali Wilson, General Counsel and Secretary to the Board of Trustees. Dr. Robert Krebs, our Honorary Faculty Marshal, President of the Faculty Senate, Professor in the Department of Biological, Geological, Environmental Sciences in the College of Sciences and Health Professions, and faculty representative to the Board of Trustees. Yes, Babu has lots of hats. Representing Cleveland State University's Board of Trustees, David Reynolds, Chair, Timothy Cosgrove, Vice Chair, Vanessa Whiting, Alan Starkoff, Arlindo Armitage, Student Representative, Brittany Summers, Student Representative, Adam Sonstegard, Faculty Representative. Thank you, you may be seated. Graduates, family members, special guests, friends, faculty, colleagues, welcome again to the 2022 Spring Commencement Ceremony of Cleveland State University. We are all grateful for your presence as we celebrate the remarkable accomplishments of our graduating seniors. Commencement ceremonies are a time-honored tradition in higher education. They are steeped in ritual. They give us the opportunity to pause in our busy lives, to reflect, to savor, and to celebrate in the presence of our teachers, family, and friends, the accomplishments of you, our impressive graduates who have worked so hard to get to this point. I would like to recognize the dedication of all of our faculty and staff to student success. They work hard each day to continuously deliver quality education to help our students attain their goals. This dedication has been particularly visible over the last couple of years during this global pandemic. The first graduate to walk across the stage today is no more or less important or accomplished than the last graduate to walk across the stage. And for that reason, I would sincerely like to request all of you to please settle in and remain part of this celebratory community until the entire ceremony concludes. Please do it for yourself and for your fellow graduates. Thank you. And now, it is my distinct pleasure to invite the 8th president of Cleveland State University, Dr. Laura Bloomberg, to the podium.
Thank you so much, Provost Sridhar. Graduating class of 2022, wow, congratulations. We couldn't be more proud of your accomplishments and the spirit of perseverance that brought you to this day. This is your day, and I really, really hope you will savor every moment of it. To the family members and the friends here to celebrate these students, and to those of you watching from home, we're so glad that you're here with these students and with all of us on this special day. Graduates, as you reflect on your experience at Cleveland State University, I'm guessing there are a few phrases that you wouldn't mind if you never heard again, or at least didn't hear again for a very long time. For instance, the term midterms, or maybe final exams, or this is my favorite, maybe the phrase 8 a.m. class. But I hope that there are other messages that you will hear today, and I hope they are never going to grow old for you. Congratulations. You deserve this. You set a goal for yourself, and you achieved it. Be proud of yourselves. And then let's face it, there are other terms and expressions that you will hear for better or worse, and they will forever be tied to this graduating class of 2022. Things like attending college during unprecedented times, global pandemic, remote learning, emerging into a new normal. In the past few academic years, we all know you have had to routinely adapt to the changing conditions of a global pandemic. You've had to attend classes while observing new rules and procedures and guidelines that you as students have never had to follow before. And we as educators didn't either. And sometimes those guidelines changed with dizzying frequency as the pandemic changed and we adapted. And you navigated all of that, and still you are here today. So while global pandemic and unprecedented times and emerging into a new normal do in part describe your college experience, they do not define you. Here's what I believe defines this graduating class of 2022. You are determined, you are flexible, you are patient and resilient, adaptive, and you are learners. One of my favorite 20th century writers and philosophers is a guy named Eric Hoffer. Eric Hoffer was an interesting character. He spent a significant part of his young adult life dirt poor with untreated addiction and mental health challenges, living on Skid Row. By the end of his life as an old, healthy man, Eric Hoffer had received the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Because between that time he spent on Skid Row and the time he died an old man decades later, he got healthy and he explored the world, and as a lifelong learner, he became a brilliant philosopher of his time. He fascinates me. And there's one line in particular in all of Eric Hoffer's writings that has always stood out to me. And as many times as I have stood at a podium for commencement, I have shared this line because I think it's so apt. But today, to this graduating class of 2022, I think it's more powerful than ever. Eric Hoffer wrote this: "In times of great change, learners inherit the earth. It is the learners who inherit the future, while the learned find themselves beautifully equipped to inhabit a world that no longer exists." The skills you developed here at Cleveland State as a student during unprecedented times, your capacity to learn and to adapt, to roll with the punches, to be resilient, it will serve you well over a lifetime. While you have learned a lot here, you are also prepared to inherit the future, not only because of what you've learned, but because you have learned how to learn. My greatest wish for you is that you carry that into your future. Be always a learner. Be a lifelong learner. We know that none of us follows the path of learning alone. We don't learn in a vacuum. You have had teachers, mentors, allies, and guides all along the way. And this is, get a little choked up here, this is the special gift. This is the contribution of our faculty who are so very dedicated to your success. I would ask my fellow faculty members if they would please rise, both here on the podium and in the audience. Please rise. All of the faculty members, wherever you are. I think it's important to note that even as these scholars are so invested in the success of our students, they themselves are on a lifelong path. They have pledged to a lifelong path of inquiry and curiosity themselves. So we are in good company when I talk about being lifelong learners. And faculty, you have meant so much to this journey for our students, and I personally thank you. Graduates, you are also surrounded by a village that has supported you. Those people in your network, the provost mentioned them, the supporters who are your encouragers and who give you strength. They may be your parents and grandparents, aunties and uncles, brothers and sisters, spouses and children and partners, and dear, dear friends. Perhaps they're with us today, or perhaps they're watching live from their home. Regardless of where they are, I would hope you would take a moment with me to stand and show them your gratitude. Go ahead, graduates, let's show them your gratitude. That's maybe the best part of the whole event right there. Thank you all so very much. And now it is my great honor and privilege to introduce to you the chair of the Cleveland State University Board of Trustees, Mr. David Reynolds, who brings greetings on behalf of the board to this graduating class of 2022. Chair Reynolds.
Thank you, President Bloomberg. And on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to welcome you to family and friends to graduation. This is a momentous occasion, commencement. This is the day to celebrate and reflect on all that you've learned and accomplished while here at Cleveland State University. From our student athletes giving it all on the court, to our researchers in the labs working to solve the ever-evolving complex problems, to our theater and dance students who pour their hearts into their heart and their performances. Cleveland State and our students serve as a true beacon for our community and beyond. I'm very fortunate to serve as the Board of Trustees, Chairman of the Board of Trustees at Cleveland State University, and I have personally witnessed the true value of a Cleveland State University degree. And on behalf of our Board of Trustees, I want to say congratulations. I know that you will go far in your endeavors and that you will represent our Viking family in all that you do. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Chair Reynolds. And now I am absolutely delighted to introduce this morning's commencement speaker, Congresswoman Chantel Brown. Congresswoman Brown is a Cleveland native and dedicated public servant. She represents Ohio's 11th Congressional District, which includes both Cleveland and Akron. It's that skinny district that goes right down from Cleveland. She's also chairwoman of the Cuyahoga County Democratic Party. Congresswoman Brown previously served as a council member for Cuyahoga County and as a city council member for Warrensville Heights. She is known as a unifying leader working across the aisle to improve the district by advocating for high quality education, effective human services, and new projects that will lead to more jobs and more economic development for the region. The Congresswoman and I spoke yesterday on the phone and earlier today, and I just know that she is so excited for you and so invested in your success. It's palpable. And if I may say, unscripted for a moment, it's kind of fun to know that just a week ago, the Congresswoman was both sitting where you were and standing where she'll be standing today, not in this arena, but in another commencement ceremony. So I've got to say, we're really proud of you too, Congresswoman. And then the final thing I have to say, just because it's just very moving to me, graduates, as you were all processing in, a number of us were standing up on the fifth floor looking down, and I was standing by the Congresswoman, and we both got a little choked up watching you walk in and hearing pomp and circumstance, talking about what a day of opportunity and potential this is. So it is with that sentiment and that real sense of goodwill that I encourage you to join me in welcoming to the podium Congresswoman Chantel Brown.
Oh, goodness. Thank you. Good morning, Vikings! I would first like to thank President Bloomberg for the kind introduction, and please join me in congratulating Dr. Bloomberg, who recently took over as Cleveland State's 8th president. Dr. Bloomberg, I look forward to continuing to work with Cleveland State under your leadership, and to the Board of Trustees, the Cleveland State faculty and staff, and all who made this day and this ceremony possible. It is an incredible honor to be here today. And of course, congratulations to the class of 2022. Let's hear for all the students graduating today. Cleveland natives, students from across the U.S., international students, non-traditional students, first-generation students like myself, students who struggled to wake up for 8 a.m. classes like myself, and those who had no problem doing so. This graduating class consists of individuals with an array of backgrounds and experiences, and that is a good thing. Just like our nation at large, diversity of ideas, ideals, and identities in our classroom is our strength. But class of 2022, you all have one thing in common. Your path to this moment has been anything but direct. You all persevered through 2 years of, as Dr. Bloomberg mentioned, an unprecedented global pandemic that changed how and where we learn. Many of you had to find new ways to support yourselves and your families through as school and the economy flagged and jobs were lost. You have been tested in ways unimaginable to those who sat in those seats before you. And yet, by virtue of the fact that you are here today, You overcame. Now, I know just how important support from family and friends are through periods of growth and change, and let me just say that I see a lot of parents and family members here in the Wolstein Center today, so let's give them a big round of applause to all of those who made this day possible for you and your classmates. This is their day, too. Now, for those of you who may not be aware, Cleveland's very own Marcia Fudge, the esteemed Secretary of the Department of Housing and Urban Development, delivered last year's commencement address here at Cleveland State. Now, when Secretary Fudge, my dear friend and mentor, left Congress last year to join the President's cabinet, I entered the race to fill her seat in Ohio's 11th Congressional District in the House of Representatives, and last November, I'm proud to say, I was blessed to be elected by the people of Northeast Ohio to succeed her again in office, and hope to do so again in this coming November. Now, to some, following twice in Secretary Fudge's footsteps might seem like a coincidence, but let me just say this. If she happens to win the lottery, you know where you can find me. But all jokes aside, these were some pretty large shoes to fill, and I was sworn into office just 2 days after my election, so I didn't exactly have much time to put on those big shoes. Representing nearly 700,000 Northeast Ohioans is a great honor that comes with great obligation and a privilege that comes with more than a little pressure. But by no means did my charge to serve others begin when I was sworn in. No, it was cultivated over a decade ago when I was a private sector worker and asked myself a simple question: how can I help those in my community? The question was, where would I find or where would we go in the event of an emergency? And that led me to my very first city council meeting. And I attended the meeting, and what I learned was there was some room for improvement. So rather than complain, I am a person that believes in being the change that you want to see. So I rolled up my sleeves, pounded the pavement, introduced myself to my neighbors, and I said, I want to be your city council person. And they said, what can you do about this pothole in the front of my yard? The tree branches that need to be trimmed, and the sewers that need to be cleaned. Well, because I continued to attend those meetings, I cultivated relationships with the administration. And they said, if you need some help out there, let us know. Well, I took them up on that offer, and next thing you know, tree branches started getting trimmed, potholes started getting filled, and sewers started getting cleaned. So I was feeling pretty good about life. So fast forward, election day came, and the polls closed, and I was down by 6 votes, ladies and gentlemen. 6 votes. I actually thought, I'm never running for public office again. Besides, I was getting things done, and I trust God's infinite wisdom. I said, this must not be for me. But what I didn't know is there were 23 provisional ballots in my race. 11 days later, I learned that I had won that race by 7 votes. Yes, 7 votes. So thank you. But there's a testimony in that. Every vote really does count. But as a child of faith, 7 represents perfection, completion, and God. And so I often credit this journey of public service to His divine intervention, grace, mercy, and favor. And that has been the moral compass, the guiding force, and the foundation in this work that I call purposely public service. I share this story for several reasons. Today, we are here to celebrate all that you have accomplished despite the obstacles, or perhaps because of them. But for most of you, this marks not the beginning of an end, but the end of the beginning. Some of you will become teachers, while others may become social workers. Some will climb the corporate ladder, while others will choose a life of public service. Some will enter the workforce as engineers, while others might enter the arts. And I suspect for some, this marks only the start of your journey in higher education. Whatever your next step may be, I encourage you to follow your heart while listening to your head. Finding and realizing your purpose can be more than a little intimidating. I would venture to say it can be a bit scary. It won't always be straightforward, and it certainly won't happen overnight. But if you hold your values close and maintain your sense of curiosity, you can realize your life's calling. Take it from me. I never expected to stand here before you today as a member of Congress. A little over a decade ago, I was a marketing professional and entrepreneur. Now, don't get me wrong, I deeply enjoyed my career and learned many important skills along the way. But it was a simple yet powerful question that led me to that local city council meeting. And it was that same curiosity that brought me back for more meetings. By continuing to show up, I gained knowledge and learned from my elected officials. And slowly but surely, I saw a new way to channel my deep desire to serve others. As a child of faith, I feel it was this curiosity that helped me discover God's plan. But perseverance was also key. I thought I had lost my first race for public office. There were more than a few times that I stumbled or came up short. And who wouldn't have their fair share of doubts about whether they are prepared to become a member of Congress? The road is often unclear and uneven, but by staying true to yourself and your personal pursuits, you will make headway towards your final destination, and you will arrive stronger because of the trials and tribulations. So whenever the road is hardest, the cynics the loudest, and there will be cynics, or the personal doubts the strongest, keep pushing forward. Find new ways to overcome the odds. Find new ways to recover from the shortfalls. And find new ways to make progress towards your goals. And remember that learning has no time limit or age restriction. I encourage each of you to commit a lifetime of learning. If you are truly devoted to personal growth and progress, ask questions, seek input, test your ideas, and learn from your mistakes. Whether in the classroom or on the job, in the community, or among your friends and family, challenge yourself to set your sights higher. In Congress, I've engaged in a learning process that can oftentimes feel like drinking water from a fire hose. And just last week, I was proud to become the first in my family to complete college by earning my bachelor's degree from Wilberforce University. Thank you. When I graduated from John Adams High School, I took an unconventional path. I didn't go to college right away. I entered the workforce, and at that time, you can earn a decent living without having a college degree. From then, I earned my way and paid my way through Cuyahoga Community College, another institution that I am a proud alumni of. Thank you. And then in my 40s, I discovered the Klein Program and recently earned my degree. So, again, progress doesn't come automatic or easily, but by finding your purpose, remaining curious, persevering, and committing to a lifetime of learning, you can leverage the skills God has blessed you with to move our country forward. That is what has made America great in centuries past, and it is what makes America great today. Ordinary citizens capable of accomplishing extraordinary things together. Today, it can often feel like the future of our democracy and our country and our world hangs in the balance. Divisions of color and class, party and persuasion tear at the fabric of America. War rages abroad. The threat of climate change looms large. And here in Cleveland, poverty, hunger, and homelessness remain stubbornly high. But this is not a time for despair. This is a time for a new generation of citizens bonded by love of community and country to come together and change our nation for the better. I am hopeful. Hopeful because as I look out at the faces that make up the class of 2022, I see strength, I see courage, I see determination, I see progress, I see people ready and willing to use their talents and time to push our country forward towards justice, towards progress, and towards a brighter future for us all. Your generation will answer pivotal questions about who we are as a country and who we aspire to be. So as you celebrate this important chapter in your life's journey, move forward with purpose and resolve to the next. Stay true to yourself and always aspire to something more. By doing so, you will not only find your life's meaning, but also come to embody the essential American spirit. Thank you and congratulations again to the class of 2022.
Wow. Congresswoman Chantel Brown, you are an inspiration. Thank you so much for your words. There were so many gems of wisdom there. I'm inspired, and I imagine our graduates are too. Okay, graduates, this is the time in the ceremony where things start to get really real for all of you. We will begin conferring degrees at the doctorate, the graduate, and then the undergraduate level.
Hello, my name is John Hokum, and I am the Dean of the College of Graduate Studies. Will the candidates from Cleveland State University's College of Graduate Studies, spring class of 2022, for the doctoral degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Education, Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Studies and Public Affairs, please rise? Madam President, I have the honor to present to you each candidate from Cleveland State University's College of Graduate Studies, class of 2022. The doctoral degree is the highest degree awarded by a university. It indicates that the recipient has significantly advanced the knowledge and practice within their discipline. To recognize this outstanding level of accomplishment, the Academy honors the recipient with the awarding of a doctoral hood and the distinguished title of doctor. Please hold your applause for each candidate until after they are introduced to the audience with their new title. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Shitakshi Madhav Dahal. Shitakshi is being hooded by Dr. Anith Ram Hormuthy. I present Dr. Shitakshi Madhav Dahal. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Tausif Muhammad Hassan. Tausif Muhammad Hassan is being hooded by Dr. Srinivas Alena. I present you Dr. Tausif Muhammad Hassan. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Taban Laramian. Tabad Laramian is being hooded by Dr. Tushar Borker. I present you Dr. Taban Laramian. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Shubo Zhang. Shubo is being hooded by Dr. Zhicheng Gao. I present you Dr. Xubu Zhang. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Education, Zun Sung. Zun is being hooded by Dr. Liqing Chen Wang. I present you Dr. Jun Sung. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Education, B. M. Towns. B. M. Towns is being hooded by Dr. Anne Galetta. I present you Dr. B. M. Towns. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Education, Meng Yan. Meng Yan is being hooded by Dr. Carla Hamlin Mansour. I present you Dr. Meng Yan. Receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Urban Studies and Public Affairs, Marceline Renee Saxton. Marceline Renee Saxton is being hooded by Dr. Nicholas Zingal. I present you Dr. Marceline Renee Saxton. This concludes the conferring of doctoral degrees.
Thank you, Dean Holcomb. As we prepare to confer degrees, first, it is my privilege to introduce the University Valedictorian of the Class of 2022, Mr. Caleb Palagi, who is graduating summa cum laude with a Bachelor of Electrical Engineering degree from the Washkowitz College of Engineering. Welcome, Mr. Palagi.
Since we began our time here at Cleveland State University, each of us has made countless journeys to and from our campus, none of which would have been possible without bridges. The Inner Belt Bridge, the Valley View Bridge, the Detroit Superior Bridge. Each of these bridges are the only means by which many of us could make our trek to campus. These bridges were built by someone who decided that the journey must be made easier for the traveler coming after. A decision that can only be made after facing the same difficult path, reaching the destination, and then choosing to turn around to help those coming after. Each of us here finds ourselves in the same situation. We've overcome numerous obstacles during our college journey, and we are just moments away from the destination, life after graduation. This leaves each of us with a decision. Will I turn back and build the bridge for another? The easy choice is to focus on oneself and to just keep trying to make it across the next seemingly impassable path to the next destination. For some of us, that may be graduate programs. For others, entering the workforce. Each of these future decisions comes with new sets of obstacles that we have not yet faced. Most of us have been told at least once in our lives to keep moving forward, and eventually all of these difficulties will be in the rearview mirror, and you can forget about them, right? Not quite. I ask that you take the time to step back, reflect, and look behind you. You will find that there are more than just the vestiges of the struggles you overcame, but people, yes, people, who are struggling with the same exact challenges you faced. You'll see your friends, your siblings, maybe even your children, fighting the same battles you did. And just like you, they're searching for a guide, a mentor, who has the knowledge that one only acquires by overcoming hardship, who builds bridges for others, and who out of generosity empowers all coming after to fearlessly face the next challenge. Graduating from Cleveland State University has given each of us here the opportunity to be that helping hand to those in need. Some people here today have already taken that first step to mentoring the traveler behind them by student teaching in local schools, engaging clients in music therapy, or by working as a tutor in the math learning center or the writing center. Or maybe it was as simple as going home and helping a sibling, a neighbor, a son or daughter with that homework problem that just seemed too hard until you explained it in a new way. As Saint Teresa of Calcutta said, never worry about the numbers. Help one person at a time, and always start with the person nearest you. No matter how small that first step might have been, it made that person's journey just that much easier. Many of my bridge builders are here today. Thank you to my parents, family, and girlfriend for their support and patience, and for reminding me that there is more to life than just engineering. Thank you to the priests and teachers at St. Ignatius High School, who showed me that a St. Ignatius education exists not to make you better than everyone else, but to make you better for everyone else. To my high school Science Olympiad coaches, and to Cleveland State's Newman Catholic Campus Ministry for giving me the tools to answer the question, what does God want from me? And for forming me into the engineer I am today and the teacher I hope to become in the future. Lastly, thank you to my Cleveland State Washkowitz College of Engineering professors, Mr. Rarick and Drs. Dong, Gao, Stankovic, and Chu, for making engaged learning more than just a tagline, but an authentic, tangible reality over these last 4 years. Class of 2022, as you sit anxiously waiting to walk across the stage today, take the time to reflect on who your bridge builders have been. Think about who has helped form you into the person you are now. And after you leave here today, having finally achieved what we all have worked so hard to achieve, go out into the world and thank those bridge builders in your life, and strive to become a bridge builder yourself. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Liz Layfelt, and I am the Dean of the Jack, Joseph, and Morton Mandel Honors College. It is my pleasure to introduce the college valedictorians of the class of 2022. I ask each of you to rise and be recognized as I call your name. Shelby Seberg, who is graduating summa cum laude, receiving a Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science degree from the College of Sciences and Health Professions, and two Bachelor of Arts degrees from the Maxine Goodman Levin College of Urban Affairs, one in Urban and Regional Studies, and the other in Environmental Studies. A round of applause for Shelby, please. Jessica Sawaya, who is graduating summa cum laude, receiving a Bachelor of Science in Education in Special Education, Moderate Intensive Educational Needs from the College of Education and Human Services. A round of applause for Jessica. As Dean of the Mandel Honors College, I would also like to call your attention to those students who are graduating as honors and scholars students of the Jack, Joseph, and Morton Mandel Honors College. These students are wearing a distinctive stole in recognition of their outstanding academic achievement. I would ask all of you graduates of the Mandel Honors College to please rise and be recognized. And at this point, you can be seated. At this point in the program, we will begin conferring degrees by college in order of recognition.
All right, this is the fun part. Madam President, I have the honor to present to you each candidate of Cleveland State University's class of 2022 for all the various bachelor and master's degrees and whose names appear in the printed program.
Good morning. My name is Sajid Zachariah, and I'm the Dean of the College of Education and Human Services. Madam President, the following are candidates for bachelor's degrees from the College of Education and Human Services.
Abrian Rigo. Jessica Ritchie. Rosvetta Moore. Imani Simmons. Amani Mahmoud El Hatib. Tamara Newton. Riley Hutchison. Alexia Rodriguez. Francesca Cipriano. Gabriella Beard. Carly Ann Fort. Kennedy S. Kurtz. Amanda Mungalier. Olivia Schaefer. Elise Tidmore. Taylor Nicole Murphy. Julia King. Caitlin Zeitz. Valerie Arnold. Alicia Danielle Geyer. Victoria L. Popovich. Victoria Ponte. Connor G. Eli. Evan Ardell Phelps. Hannah Schmidt. Sophia Virginia Christopher. Emily R. Herner. Brandion E. Hill. Hannah M. Ziegler. Sandra Becerril. Ala A. Karapunarli. Alina Denevchik. Killian Netzer. Emily Patricia Feketi. Sierra Nicole Androver. Evie Maria Sigas. Molly Anna Guzman. Sarah M. Garner. Amina Mary. Evan Taylor. Mary Beth Williams. Shelby R. Kelby. Rachel Bokros. Megan R. McKay. Aaron Nicole Bowerman. Ava Victoria Zupants. Jessica Marie Sawaya. Kimberly Ann Toich. Kayla Trout. Chandler McCurry. Paige Novell. Taylor Nicole Tonsing. Faith Paulina DeSico. Carissa Gabrielle Mills. Addison L. Pretnar. Dina H. Ali. Julia Maria Riley. Hannah Ramito. Heather Beeble. Jacqueline Beller. Jerry Appia Minsa. Akeem Jamal Rollins. Joshua Thomas Trexler. Hamza Mansour. Joseph S. Oko. John J. Seifert. August J. Vulo. Ashley Taylor Sutz. Hannah Catherine Wolf. Erica Hobbs. Serena Valencia Moore. Hannah M. Cooper. Antasia Tasha Matthews. Mercedes Erlina Farmer. Sean Schick. Kyle Wilson. Frankie Bolden. Dania Altahir. Trevor Schroeder. Jacqueline Grace Felton. Ben Sternberg. Sean Michael Moran. Alexander M. Miser. Meredith Hope Chapka. Jordan William D'Ameda. Jessica Lynn Jacobet. Olivia Reinhardt. Sarah Patton.
Madam President, the following are master's candidates from the College of Education and Human Services.
Monique Witherspoon. Crystal White. Lathrisa A. Smith. Elise Grover. Danielle Stark. Natalie Tumba. Courtney Tiara Gardner. Rachel Flynn. Winter J. Pitts. Howard Jackson. Mohammed Jebrin. Tamara Bailey. Victoria Newitt. Jennifer Leiby. Ellie Jude Cole. Margot Murphy Spate. Kayla Lonzo. Jasmine Anderson. Aaron A. Robinson. Darby Bomberger. Kaylee Rykola. Samantha E. Fodor. Caitlin Guiley. Gina Coscone. Annie Myatt. Emily Riddle. Angelique Rochelle Lifford. Elena Paparezos. Dana Vike. Blake Nicole Gillum. Aziz Ahmad. Erica Alamdar. Rochelle Shantae Jones. Jessica Latoya Jones. Anne Marie Wimmer. Chad Matthew Thompson. Adam D. Haller. Nicole C. Nora. Wed Jamal Kareem. Rachel Pierce. Kristen M. Call. Philippe Deaton. Joseph Stridiot. Emily Mo Cadlow. Aisha Tinker Phelps. Brian J. Madden. Dallas Antonio Woods. Rachel Elizabeth Astorino. Douglas Neil Davis. Courtney Jean Elkins. Mary Claire France. Amanda Rachel Townsend. Emily Ann Dimitriadis. Nicole Iyengar. Abby Elizabeth Smiley. Casey Renee Semplak. Taylor Maisani Hendershot. Kimberly F. Tate. Wei Chen Lin. Lindsay Griesmer. Catherine Ann Van Key. Jordan Poo Chin Ali. Nathan Lucas Jones. Ajayla Fontaine Powers. Ravza Ozturk. Kayla M. Sakarik. Noelle Scanlon. Hope Paul. Samantha Elizabeth Montel. Nadia Fuchs. Diana Marcella Bermudez. Shakoy Warren. Jaylee Letcher. Tangina Harris. April Davina Waltone. Brittany Snodgrass. Ziobi He. Magna Giselle Coyoso. Rachel Thompson. Kayla Jordan Mitchell. Cassandra Petro. Abby Lynn Marshall. Alexandra Russ. Karen Sue Naren. Wanice Gentress Glass. Hannon Jamal Al Ojali. Kaylin Michelle Ferguson. Jordan William Crendo. Sydney Elizabeth Stein. Malika Hill. Brianna Babiaka. Nicole M. Horn. Emily J. Mills. Brooke Madison Lepp. Megan Berg Donnelly. Mary K. Shelton. Delvante Greer. Tiana Marie Banks. Reva Telfer. Shannon Marie Smith. Alexandria Renee Finowski. Devin Greer.
Good morning. My name is Richard Shepoyster, and I am Dean of the Washkowitz College of Engineering. Madam President, the following are candidates for bachelor's degrees in the Washkowitz College of Engineering.
Dawood Hamza Sharif. Fatan Adnan Mansour. Sureen Mustafa. Bashir Abjurade. Adam Barghouti. Mohammed Alodat. Mickey Fleming. Joseph Wolf. Hope Zaire. Seth Haller. Sarah Rachel Toth. George Sam Ayub. Tanner Larson. Brandon Hepe. Mubarak Hussein Alajmi. Malik Al-Hamad. Daniel David Rohr. Yatin Bharatkumar Patel. Matthew Battaglia. Stephen Bengal. Jacob Mundorf. Tyler Snyder. Micah Vertal. Thomas Lombardo. Jason Andres Garcia Nino. Daniel Lemosik. Zachary Bryant. Troy James Dorney. Alexander Elliott Wickman. Elizabeth Claire Wayman Heller. Trevor Kasky. Elena Ann Lindsay. Ashley Sharon Fisher. Adam Youssef Suleiman. Eric Hamden. Antoine Golfin. Michael Fugate. Robert Lennart. Sean McDermott. Jason Berry. Stephen David Phillips. Stipe Remotz. Nathan Stevenson. Jacob Zuniga. Hassan Mataki. Abdullah Al-Khalifi. Carlo Vittoria Valletta. Salahadin Lametsev. Trevor Nice. Nicole Ramirez. Christina Ortiz. Brendan Michael Kelly. Maximilian Evans. James Elder. Nathan Porchonsky. Ala Bukhari. Mohammed Ibrahim Abdallah. Issa Bouzaid. Hanin Hamid. Nishad Durasori. Michael Stifler. Zane Rhea. Corey Dolly. Dorian Piccola. Julie Lindstrom. Logan Gerald Reardens. Matthew Tirabassi. Jacob Molnar. Chester Olenuch. Samantha Deachin. Caitlin Phillips. Colin D'Alessandro. Benjamin Smith. Joshua Rogowski. Quan Nguyen. Omar Colt. Dominic Montez. Jack Schaefer. Richard Flack. Bailey Filer. Ian Cubberly. Joseph Rebuck. Herbie Rera. Christian Bainbridge. Marco Varga. Alexandria Grace Badza. Matthew Swintek. Erica Lynn Rolke. Emily Zhao. Ian Wu. Valerie Jarvis. Richard Sent. Nathan Dixon. Nicholas Cleary. Aiden Zapotechny. Decibel Amariti. Ala Al-Hassan. Eugene Dobrakov. Roman Melnick. Justin Ryan Ordonez. Curtis Joseph Gatch. Peter Barnacki. Hannah Wakefield. Kirsten Nicole Penny. Jordan Richard Robison. Joseph Peary. Mohammed Montasser. Kirk Whitaker. Marco Komlionevich. Chris Chahon. Daniel Alexander Mikalion. Peter Abdelmalek. Diana Mustafa. Rebecca Ellis. Mackenzie Marie Tucker. Ruth Kurek. Ashley Michaela McCartney. Adam Lee Jackson. Kevin Clinton Stropke. Adam Katsaris. Aaron Stocker. Landon Lee Oglesby. Marcus William Whitlinger. Casey Fisher. Natalie Bubnik. Akosh Rafi. Ozgun Kamil Erdin. Tariq Teya. Milica Yandrich. Karim Nasreldin. Zarina Marie Dagalia Legitimus. Judy Jarwich Ahmad. Dana Water. Christina Al-Kolek. Omar Zaran Al-Kadan. Trevor Edwards. Austin Corlett. Jordan T. Clagg. Joseph Cipolla. Mahmoud Ahmed. James Samandel. Aaron Teeters. Joshua Covarrubias. Jared M. Simcoe. David Hornickel. Kataline Chindea.
Mr. Cat.
Yeah. Christopher Ryan Nisick. Emmett McGrath. Jordan Ray Kuzma. Ashish Patel. Mihir Vasoya. Danish Mohsen Iqbal. Alexis Goriantz. Andrew Gettel Sayed. Scott P. Hines. Jacob Gobrile. Andrew Ross. Kira Stovacek. London Boss. Costadina Kozanis. Luen Mong. Jonathan Mark Celestina. James Lewis Major. Ikechukwu Chukwukere. Jason Al-Hassawi. Khaled Alanezi. Bader Jawi. Fahad Alabkal. Hanabi Rashid. Meshari Alanezi. Abdul Mashid Al-Shati. Mohammed Al-Kayat. Idris Jawa. Abdullah Al-Saidi. Osama Youssef Al-Balushi. Ryan M. Strasser. Alexander Clementi. Haydar Bektash. Layla Khalid Rumadan. Harwa Rumadan. Lolwa Bader Ali Kub. Fajir Ali Al Salem.
Madam President, the following are candidates of master's degree from the Washkowitz College of Engineering.
Sujesh Tipavhari. Abhijit Naval. Nikhil Kumar Pasapataleti. Ajay Pawari, Jijin Kotali Raghavan, Shivam Sharma, Ankur Priyadarshi, Yasharth Singh, Vineet Garahamnani, Sagar Samrat Motha. Venkatesh Batula. Tanmay Chaudhary Valamudi. Shande Sarivinas. Gauri Guntur. Nishay Patel. Garang Patel. Shandini Priya Tumala. Namrata Chaudhary. Shreshit Swanson. Ishwara Jakumar. Jankita Sai Rupa Vengala. Somyokta Kodamori. Michael Raymond Como. Paul Antonescu. Harry Arnold. Alex Demko. Jordan Funk. Rachel Suter. Ola Jamal Ali. Bhavaswari Madeva. Vamsi Chikura. Yash Majaya. Umar Jaiv. Akash Desea. Vendant Duredom Remy. William Boatler. Brian L. Kohut. Irina Venswelvik. Bamevra Kavra Chowdhury. Swentra Swayambhutya. Robert Zink. Norman Barona. Dehitha Lavu. Manaswina Chiaju. Calvin Christopher. Varun Sayuth. Abel Jose. Lokaranja Rakakrishnan. Jacob Bayer. Shivam Joshi. Mokashita Chandrasekhar. Vashniva Chiramshyeti. Sumaya Ahmed. Lauren Lautier. Taylor Street Rishuti.
Hello, my name is Allison Robichaud, Interim Dean for the College of Liberal Arts and Social Sciences. Madam President, the following are the candidates for bachelor's degrees from the College of Liberal Arts and Social Sciences.
Levon Brock. Gabriela Marie Quintano. Melanie Marie Thompson. Taviana Carr. Brittany Amber Smith. Sejana Rustamai. Ashley Hannah. Heather Anderson. Eugenia Merritt. Olivia Chanel. Ashley Meacha. Samra Karamustafik, Eric Seitz, Brittany Ann Merck, Brooke Armbruster, Megan Kane, Olivia D. Havis, Erica Ramos, Joey Jingleski, Sam Miller, Lindsay Novak, Olivia Renee Demby, Jake Reggie, Sadie Pinckney, Sharla Durand, Natalie Claire Dianchand, Hannah Elizabeth Rosendahl, Shomari Trammell Blythewood, Shannon Pippick, Nora Conroy, Peyton Mack, Davis Chu, Abigail McDowell, Carly Watton, Lauren Colizar, Becca Ross, Marissa Ostromek, Kelsey Fanter, Amel Guafong, Barbara Zinuska, Erica Gifford, Deborah Claire Parcham, Anna Bratton, Zoe Caitlin Coffey, Camille Couture, Monica Renee Hill, Marilise Gabrielle Cedres, Stephanie Herring, Morgan Alexia Brennan, Shaylin Casey, Katie Schmucker, Mariah Montavo, Nashleen Natal Falu, Shaquila Patterson, Kiana Smith, Taylor King, Emily Brozaitis, Allison Marie Nichols, Grace Swank, Riley Robain, Kate Keller Gammons Nardi, Tyra Lucero Cheney, Emily Alexis Pullman, Gina Tedesco, Angela Harris, Mia Bryant, Tessa Hartman, Sarah Benny, Julian Michael Redondo, Douglas Smith, Joni Zakral, Jordan Charles Leverett. Alexis Galvin. Nicole Fulginity. Catherine Noralewski. Anthony Pesta. Diamond Rutherford. Samantha Barron. Catherine Hemming. Daniel Ethan Tofill. Alyssa Derma. Miranda Dorsey. Zachary Golden. Rachel Elizabeth Bartonelli. Alex M. Town. Sean Michael McConnell. Brian Lachowski. Patrick Graylis. Alexander Picturna. Peyton Ann Gandalf. Emma Rose Carroll. Amber Shunk. Michelle Mary Fiorta. Mary Frances Nozak. Agnes Ruth Barr. Emily Hertrick. Emily Hetrick. Excuse me. Theo James Malloy. Lindsay Renee Turbank. Arwa Elma Shea. Alicia Lopresti. Katura Lynn Pleasant. Lily Joanne Stockbridge. Alexandra Lee Kell. Robert Lane Fenbers. Austin Miller. Michaela Paige Thornton. Natalia Rowe. Kaylin Stahl. Jared Dubber. Rebecca Smith. Alexander Frank Nowitzki. Farah El Ashram. Kara Rovella. Shalom Oliver. Mahela Stoya Mihai. David Wheatley. David Haynes. Jacob Humphreys. Soliad Caracini. Nikayla Dawn Wiggins. Abby Bennington. Kennedy Lee Allen. Cole Soma. Jamie Troy. Christina McIntosh. Maha Masood. Angel Montiagudo. Atiya Najjar. Abdullah Bashar Hamdan. Nicole Marie Liskowski. Kiera Phillips. Daya Guri. Brandon Varnado. Chase Andrew Phillips. Roberto Valletta. Joanna Perry. Peter Van Drasik. Caitlin Elizabeth Resnick. Samantha Jamal. Alyssa Kalfi. Shannon Driscoll. Tim Pham. Kamal Sorrells. Anthony Shirappa. Selena Rios. Katie Schuster. Dana Omar Ashagali. Emma Spleet. Jillian Van Dyke. Connor Hughes. Maximilian Menkaus. Ala Ed Saleh. Nautica C. Jones. Oliver James Ellis. Taylor Patricia Fee. Antoinette Sprinkle. Nicholas Lane. Sydney Ariana Wheeler. Nina Simone Mason. Sarah Heggs. Amira Jasser. Amaya Anderson. Stuart Adler Jones. Shah Nawaz Salim. Chelsea Davis. Jacqueline Bugay. Victoria Sui. Briaja Morgan. Cheyenne Jordan. Kira Smith. Miranda Michelle Kyle. Devin Claybrooks. Mason John Coppy. Zachary Odowole. Nora Sovaku. Lacey Burrell. David Cashier. Kathleen Cruz. Cameron Lee Anderson. Michael Schlosser. Andre Love. Aaliyah Johnson Heicha. Renee Moore. Casey Green. Emma Bryson. Elena Siner. Charles Williams Jr. Matthew Hunter Jr. Alex Feliciano. Maya Ballard. Leandris Davis. Seamus Walter Winchester. Jordan Hope Carruthers. Karina Grossel. Ronice Elizabeth Edmund Story. Razia Tian Hernton. Sydney Monet Adibo. Joe Murray. Haley Rory. Eric Townsend Jr. Jacob Ruggles. Jacob Moore. Joseph Walsh. Lee Boston. John Kelblee. Chase Arcangelo. Michaela Chakalos. Jennifer Rizzo. Lily Lamott. Alyssa Thomas. Renata Napier. Jewel Guathney. Emma Carlson. Anna Louise Addison. Alex Hammer. Andrea Michelle Costo. Louis Folks. Matthew Harders. Juliana Maria O'Donnell. Cassidy Marie Andrews. Jack Rains. David R. Bates. Sabrina Varche Ollie. Rashida Jerome Pettis. Danielle Marie Imwasili. Fallon E. Robinson. Andrew Nicholas. Marissa Nicole Pizzulo. Champagne McCray. Tiasia Mitchell. Cameron Gomillion. Deontay Leonard Johnson. Asha Fairley. Des Moines Malik Hodge.
Sierra English.
Madam President, the following are candidates for a master's degree from the College of Liberal Arts and Social Sciences.
Haley Teal Wargo. Brianne Simon. Missalyn Boggs. Catherine Carney. Christopher Daniel Matthews. Lauren Sandra Hinkle. Madeline Hasbin. Jacob Bremkamp. Alicia Dish. Dennis Young. Gabrielle Wine. Amy K. Grills. Ina Barnhart. Carol Beck. Sabrina Wallace. Michelle McDonald. Ambrosia Sky Lucius. Alex Ashbrook. Diane Jackal Green. Dina McSweeney. Kalita O'Brien. Aaron Fraley. Aaron Jeter. Eugene Schnell. Irina Sadovic. Nareka Williams. Audrey Hancock. Heather Aurora Reardens. Patrick Sneed. Aaron Scott. Janelle Simons. Gabrielle Jouffre. Sarah Benedict. Nicole Elaine Howell. Gianna Velez. Zoe Day. Asia Straw Kai. Paola Wooten. Jessica Rose Gordon. Alicia L. Brown. Asia Martin. Jeffrey Goad. Jessica Ann Zucker. Rodney Hubbard Sr. Salithia Renee King. Jennifer Kearney. Ashley Hardy. Dana Grandy. Debbie Pepleys. Hannah Grace Jacobson. Hannah Patton. Farida Alsharani. Vanessa Dawn Buchanan. Brooke Stevens. Shannon Elizabeth Brown. Nora Mohammed Almatari. Rebecca Mannon. Mary Sapola. Brittany Buddy. Audrey Hostetler. Gavin Coogan. Mackenzie Ellen Kane. Jacqueline Horgan. Jordan Selman. McKenna McIntyre. Lauren Morawski. Crystal Drennan. Ayana Jackson. Tasha Mariana Brandt. Tamaya Bell. Callie Levan. Catherine Christiana Shea Cook. Leisha Luton. Brian Luton. Richard R. Robinson Sr. Nisha Gilmore. Tonia Deadwiley. Bartholomew Chambers. Rondale Reed Sr.
Hello, my name is Joanna Ganning, Associate Dean of the Maxine Goodman Levin College of Urban Affairs. Madam President, the following are candidates for bachelor's degrees from the Maxine Goodman Levin College of Urban Affairs.
Shelby Nicole Seberg. Bernard J. Golias Jr. Matthew Anthony Husky. Thank you. Catherine Suzanne O'Neill. Julia Maria Lagarth. Alicia M. Webster. William Spleet IV. Latonda Bailey. Joseph DiRocco Keneally. Aaron Matthews. Kevin Kohler Laffey. Connor M. Brintar. Samantha Lynn Pfister. Heidi Emile Gibson. Sophia Johnson. Paul Jason Wallace. Mohammed Al Salman. Corey Matthew Hunt. William Zayao Ming Young. William Xiaoming Young. Kayla Mary Graham. Tracy Bell. Elliot A. Jarris. John F. Brancatelli. Kimberly Shawnee Rednauer. Eternity Sachet Burrell. Matthew James Pitzer. Joseph Iannelli. Hassan Hamad. Lindsay Claire Wood. Alex Michael Shirley. Molly Francis Johnston. Jordan Yvonne Henderson. Demario Joseph Rood. Michael Allen Garrett. Raven M. Fairley. Samantha Fisher. Maria Weigen. Brittany Mary Chafer. Darius Combo Kid. Daniel Richard Carr. Troy Jeanette Greenfield. Robert Gregory Putka. Hannah R. Sauberin. Layla Blackburn. Fatima Witte.
Madam President, the following are candidates for master's degrees from the Maxine Goodman Levin College of Urban Affairs.
Michaela Marie Crumbly. Joseph Luis Scoffstall. Angela M. Jones. Molly C. Ferris. Michael Naso, Warren T. Dovsek, Donnell Walker, Graciana Mary Flanick, Antonia Gladys Walker, Amaria Arige Marie, Joshua Littler, Javine Davis Williams, Erica Rose Tenorello, Paul Joseph Triolo, Keenan Davis Fentress, Michael Nozak, Eliza Kammer, Caitlin Elizabeth Dibble, Emily Grace Daynert, Ariana Killing, Grace Lee Warren, Sean Payne, Supriya Ta Maeng,
thank you. This concludes the conferring of all degrees.
Wow. Well, our ceremony concludes with the president formally conferring doctorate, master's, and baccalaureate degrees upon the class of 2022. I ask the platform party to rise. I ask the graduating class of 2022 to rise. President Bloomberg, please return to the podium.
Class of 2022, you now join more than 140,000 graduates of Cleveland State University. We now look to you to help us continue to provide the same educational opportunities that were given to you for the next generation and the next generation and the next generation of graduates. As alumni, you are our best ambassadors of goodwill and lifelong members of the Cleveland State University community. We're so proud to know you now as alums. Graduates, we're not quite there yet. Upon the recommendation of the faculty of Cleveland State University, and by the power vested in me by the State of Ohio and the Cleveland State University Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon each individual their respective degree with all of the rights, the honors, the privileges, and the responsibilities pertaining thereto. At this time, now here's a teachable moment. I'm going to ask just the people receiving a bachelor's degree to do something, and that is because it signals the beginning of your education post-high school and the beginning of a lifelong career of learning. So at this time, I ask only the bachelor's degree recipients to move your tassels from the right to the left, which signifies recognition of earning your degree. Thank you, and I extend to you my heartiest, heartfelt congratulations.
I think another round of applause is in order. Congratulations to everybody in the class of 2022. Folks, thank you for joining us on this wonderful occasion. Graduates, I ask you to please remain standing at your seats until the platform party has recessed.
I declare these commencement exercises to be completed. Thank you.
Graduates and guests are kindly asked to please exit the Wohlstein Center gates as we prepare for the afternoon ceremony. Concessions, memorabilia, and gifts are available for purchase on the concourse level. Thank you for joining us at this monumental occasion. Thank you.